For Mason Lawley, 1991, I'm obviously biased as I worked with both of these guys. This article, though, has been so handy for me because so often behavior analysts accept diagnoses that come attached to individuals we work with, including diagnoses such as schizophrenia. In at least some cases, though, those schizophrenic-like behaviors are learned and have been inadvertently shaped by their care providers. In one case, we worked with a female adolescent who was diagnosed with autism and schizophrenia. Functional analysis results showed that they were primarily occurred in the attention condition, not what you would expect if the person really was schizophrenic. We successfully treated the bizarre statements, even in the presence of our psychiatrist, who at one rounds meeting asked us if she was still talking crazy. And I quote, "We said only with you." To his credit, he was intrigued, quit attending to her bizarre statements, and our medical team ended up by discharging her with just the autism diagnosis. She is no longer diagnosed with schizophrenia and no longer received anti-schizophrenic medications. Bottom line, functional analysis methodology should and could be applied to a wide range of behaviors. Many thanks to Lang and Andronis for a conceptual paper on this topic that appeared in the Behavior Analyst, which served as the inspiration for this article by Mason Lawley.